Hello, and welcome to our first video tutorial on how to read and use VFR sectional charts as unmanned aerial systems, or UAS, operators. This series of videos is brought to you by AmericaView, in partnership with the College of Natural Resources and Environment at Virginia Tech, the Virginia Cooperative Extension, and GeoTED UAS. Just a little bit about myself. My name is Daniel Cross, and I'm an Unmanned Aerial Systems and Geographic Information Systems Operator at Conservation Management Institute, which is a research center within the College of Natural Resources and Environment at Virginia Tech. In this series of videos, we will cover what you need to know about VFR sectional charts to operate safely as either a commercial UAS operator or a hobbyist. It's worth noting that we will not cover everything there is to know about these maps, only what is pertinent to the drone community. The subjects we will cover in this video are what is a sectional chart, and a brief tutorial on SkyVector.com. In the rest of the series, we will cover the basic parts and layout of a VFR sectional, the legend and symbology, airspace, special use airspace, and how to read a sectional chart. First, let's start with what a VFR sectional chart is. VFR sectional charts, normally abbreviated to just sectional, are a type of map released by the Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA. These are used for navigation during flight under visual flight rules, or VFR. They are 1 to 500,000 scale maps, which are named after a city in their coverage area, and contain information which is useful for pilots, such as airport locations, terrain elevation, potential obstacles, and airspace classes. There are a number of sources for sectionals. You can purchase a hard copy from any physical or online pilot store, download digital versions from the FAA in both PDF and GeoTIFF formats, get them from an aviation app on your tablet or smartphone, or use a website like SkyVector. Also, if you use ArcGIS, you can stream them from the ArcGIS server on the screen. Now that you know what a sectional is and where to find one, let's quickly go over how to use SkyVector. I would like to note that we're not promoting any specific site or service. SkyVector is just what I use for work and teaching. Now, let's go to SkyVector. There are a few differences between hard copy charts and sites or apps like SkyVector. The first difference are all of these colored points on the map. They are locations of airports with weather reporting stations. If you mouse over one of these points, a tooltip will pop up showing you the METAR, or the coded weather report, for that station. This can be a quick way to check the weather. Secondly, SkyVector displays TFRs, or temporary flight restrictions, in orange. If you mouse over a TFR, a tooltip with the TFR type, time and dates the TFR are effective, the altitudes it is effective for, and how long until it turns on will appear. If you click on the TFR, it will bring up a page with more detailed information. Since we cannot normally fly within a TFR while it is active, this page will tell you who to contact to get permission to operate within that TFR. The third feature is that SkyVector can display DROTAMs, or notices of UAS activity, that have been filed with 1-800-WX-BRIEF. We can turn these on under the DROTAM menu at the top of the page. This will display the same information as a TFR, but most of the time the altitude is listed in AGL, or above ground level. Also displayed along with DROTAMs are these purple areas, which are drone no-fly zones. These indicate that there is a military installation where we are not permitted to fly. The last feature is that you can easily display a number of different charts by selecting the chart you want to view using this array of buttons in the upper right-hand corner of the screen. By default, SkyVector uses the World VFR chart, which is what you will normally use. However, there are reasons you may want to look at an individual chart. As an example, if we select the Washington sectional, we can now see the entire chart as if it were a hard copy. This way we can see the legend, tables, and the date the chart is effective through. This is particularly important since not all digital services will give you this information, and these maps are only usable for a short time, approximately 6 months. Checking the date is the only way to ensure you're using the correct sectional. The other chart you might need is a TAC, or Terminal Area Chart, which are indicated on the sectionals by white boxes like this one. These are effectively zoomed-in sectionals in particularly congested areas, like Washington, D.C. If you ever find yourself having trouble reading the sectional in one of these areas, check the tack. It might clear things up. One last thing. Although all the extra information SkyVector provides is great, it does not replace getting a proper briefing for weather, NOTAMs, or flight restrictions. Well, that about wraps it up for this video. Please continue on to the next video in the series, where we will take a better look at a sectional chart and get familiar with their layout. Thank you for joining us, and fly safe.